still have a lot of memories of working a lot of very traumatic fatal crashes involving impaired drivers along 71 Highway.
A former Highway Patrol Superintendent, Ron Replogle, remembers delivering his first death notification in July of 1984.
A 17-year-old young man who was underage and shouldn't have been drinking crashed on his way home.
He personally knows the impact of an impaired driver after one killed a friend and fellow trooper.
He had a car stopped that night that was a drunk driver when he was struck and killed by another drunk driver.
Joplin's high numbers of DWI arrests prompted the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration to partner with the city in a unique campaign with a goal to
save lives, reduce injuries, fatalities on the roadway from impaired drivers, and really get the message out. Don't drink and drive. Don't drive impaired, actually, period, whether it be alcohol or illegal drugs, prescription drugs, if you take too much. Impairment is impairment.
A $50,000 grant in the partnership will help provide education materials and equipment for the department.
You are our frontline heroes in this fight against drunk driving.
In Joplin, Jared Swan and Katrina Jones are designated DWI officers.
It's unfortunate because it's preventable. So every night when we're running across them, it's sad that you're continually running into some of the same people over and over.
All say the goal of the We're Out There Too campaign is to prevent impaired driving by educating the public that it's a choice.
Just plan ahead. There are so many resources out there today with ride sharing, Uber and Lyft and taxis and designated drivers.
It is the community saying we don't want impaired drivers on our roads anymore.
In Joplin, Lisa Oligas, KOAM News.